All of a sudden, we were starting to move into bigger rooms, and we were touring just unbelievably relentlessly, really hard. But we were having so much fun with it that, you know, it didn't even seem like work at first. And so it was great, you know. And then that we did Decoration Day with him, and he's such a big part of that. And then we did, you know, we were already working on Dirty South by the time Decoration Day came out.
I love those two records.
And so we, you know, we're just working and working and working, and you know, and I think we broke ourselves. We worked too hard and without any kind of breathing room. And Jason was so young.
He was going hard.
He was going hard. And we were all, you know, 12, 15 years older. Yeah. You know, so we had already been through some of the stuff he was going through and kind of come out the other side and probably not totally always patient with, you know, with the young kid going through it. And he really didn't like being considered the young kid either, you know, as anyone in that age isn't going to like. And then started thinking, you know, God, these guys, they're old, you know, these old fuckers.
Trying to tell me not to drink, slow down on the blow.
We certainly weren't saying, well, that part we definitely, he did not need to do blow, but, no one needs to do blow, but he talked about this, by the way.
I'm not speaking out of school.
I know he's been very candid about it. We were a hard drinking band and a very hard living band, but it got different with him, you know, and I think he just got, you know, I think he didn't quite know how to handle the success yet either.
Yeah.
You know, it's a tough pill. It was hard at 35. So I can't imagine what it would have been like being, you know, 22. It was his first real serious band. Yeah. He'd never really been in a band before. Uh-huh. He'd always just played his songs. He was a singer songwriter. And he was writing all these songs way more than could fit on any one of our records, especially with two other writers.
Uh-huh.
You know, and so it was inevitable it was going to clash. I mean, I knew when he joined that it was just going to be a temporary thing. And then Shauna joined, and that was all great for a little while, but then then their marriage started falling apart. So we're all cooped up together, and there's all this drama and all this tension and awkward shit.
That's some good raw meat for songwriting. Huh?
Yeah, fuck that though. You know, I've been divorced twice myself. Yeah. I have plenty of fodder, you know, plus my parents' divorce. Enough. I don't need new angst. I still have a lifeline of angst I can dip into at any point in time.
The river of fury.
Yeah, it runs deep.
I got it, man. Yeah.
Well, you know, did you like his new album?
I thought it was phenomenal.
Beautiful,
I think
right?
Elephant's one of the best songs I've ever heard anybody write. Yeah. I think it's just incredible. And, yeah, it's a beautiful record. And I'm really proud of him. I'm really proud of him. I think Amanda's great. And I'm really proud of him getting his life together. And, you know, I'm... You know, I never would have said that he wouldn't do it, but I wasn't sure he would do it either. I mean, I never wanted to underestimate him, but at the same time, you know, it didn't look too good at times. I mean, when he drank, he was not good to be around. And then, like I said, adding in all that other baggage and other bullshit. And when he left the band, it was time. That was the only way for our band to continue forward was for us to part ways. And it was painful, and it was terrifying, because I didn't know if we were gonna, if it would still even, if our fans would even totally revolt, if we would lose everything. But it seemed like it was the only choice we had moving forward. You know, I think
it worked out.
Yeah, it has. We continued on, and you know, I think we're in a really great place now. And I'm thrilled to see him in such a great place.
Yeah,
now.
Well, that's good to hear. I mean, the record's great, and I'm glad you guys are okay. And you know, it's one of the weird concessions, if that's the right word, that we have to make. You know, being in the fields we're in, is that you know you see guys go down.
Yeah.
And you know, you got to get out of the way.
Yeah.
You got to do what you can. But, you know, you have to sort of, you know, kind of accept in yourself that, like, fucking, I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, by that time, we all had kids, you know. This thing we do is also our job now.
And you don't want to catch a bullet because someone else is an asshole.
Right, right. And you know, I'm likely enough just for my own assholery without that, you know. Yeah. If I'm going to take it, it needs to be for something I did, you know.
But if I'm going to take it, it needs to be for something I did. That's a life lesson right there. Whew.